Good morning, students. Hope you have enjoyed the last class. Welcome to another digital biology classroom of St. Michael's Academy. Today I am going to continue that particular chapter only, neural control and coordination, which includes synapse, receptor, neurotransmitter and central nervous system or CNS. So let's start. So in this slide we are going to discuss about receptor. Now first question is, what is receptor? From where this term is coming? The neurons has two endings, such as motor endings and sensory endings. The motor endings generally produce synapses with another neurons or form motor end plates with muscles or neuromuscular junction with the muscle. And another one is sensory endings. Sensory endings receive the afferent sensation. Hence, they are also called the receptors or sensory receptors. Now, a receptor is a cell present in the sense organs that is sensitive to specific stimuli. For example, the eyes have light receptors which can detect light, and the ears have sound receptors which can detect sound. Here is a diagram of receptor. See, total diagram has been given. Now the next one is, what is transducer? Transducer is the structure which transforms one kind of energy into another kind. So receptors are transducer. Why? Receptors transduce the external energy of the stimulus into the coat of the nerve impulse. The application of a stimulus to a receptor leads to the formation of a generated potential whose magnitude is determined by the stimulus intensity. See this diagram. This is plasma membrane. See, this is the cytoplasm. Signal transduction occurred. And after that, we are getting the response. See, this is receptor. Hormone or environmental stimulus. This is receptor, it is receiving this. After that, reactions producing second messengers, that means signal transduction is occurring. And after that, response is coming, activation of cellular responses. And this is cell wall, this is cell membrane or plasma membrane, and this is cytoplasm. Now, receptors are involved in the transformation of different types of energy, for example, light, sound, heat, pain, etc., into nerve impulse, electrical energy. Thus, receptors are called biological transducers or energy transforming device. Now, the classification of receptor. Structurally, the receptors are mainly three types: free nerve ending, encapsulated nerve ending, and specialized sensory cells. According to distribution in the body, receptors are grouped mainly into exoreceptor and interoceptor or interoreceptors. Exoreceptors are the receptors which are present mainly on the body surface and are stimulated by the stimuli arising outside the body. And interoceptors are the receptors present in the internal structure of the body. These receptors are two types, such as proprioceptors and viseroreceptors or viseroceptors. So first one, that means proprioceptors, located in the muscle, tendon, joint, etc., that provides information about body position and movements. एंड विसेरो रिसेप्टर्स प्रेजेंट इन वॉल ऑफ डिफरेंट विसेरल ऑर्गन्स. आई एम शोइंग यू द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एक्सोरिसेप्टर एंड इंटरोरिसेप्टर सेपरेटली. एग्जाम्पल्स आर देयर इन योर बुक. रीड एटलीस्ट वन एग्जाम्पल विच जस्टिफाई द दैट पर्टिकुलर क्लासिफिकेशन नेम ऑफ द रिसेप्टर. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. दिस इज द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एक्सोरिसेप्टर. क्यूटेनियस रिसेप्टर, केमोरिसेप्टर एंड टेलोरिसेप्टर और टेलरिसेप्टर. Cutaneous receptors are divided into touch, pressure, cold, warmth and pain. And chemoreceptors are divided into taste and smell. Taste includes taste buds and smell includes olfactory receptors. Teleceptors divided into vision and hearing. Vision includes rods and cones in retina. That means rod and cone cells in retina, and hearing includes hair cells in organs of Corti. That means in ear. Now, sensory receptors. Total division of sensory receptors. Sometimes you can say that exterior receptors. You can say Merkel's corpuscles, and all these things. This is mainly not in your syllabus. That's why I am not reading. Just divisions. You see these proprioceptors or proprioceptors. That is muscle spindles, Golgi tendon organs like this, periodontal mechanoreceptors, free nerve endings, Pacinian corpuscles, etc. And interoceptors includes Pacinian corpuscles and free nerve endings. Then what is interoceptors or interoceptors? They are also called, sometimes they are also called visceroceptors. Actually, visceroceptor is one of the part of interoceptors, but sometimes interoceptors only called visceroceptors. Detect stimuli in internal organs, that is viscera. That's why they are called visceroceptors. They are primarily stretch receptors in the smooth muscle of these organs. Most of the time, we are unaware of these receptors, but when the smooth muscle stretches to a certain point, we may become aware of these sensations. Also report on pressure, chemical changes in the visceral tissue and temperature. Generally, these muscles, strengthening of muscle or stretching of muscle rather happens at the time of exercise. Any type of exercise, physical exercise, it may happen. What is synapse? Synapse, also called neuronal junction, the site of transmission of electric nerve impulses between two nerve cells or neurons, or between a neuron and a gland or muscle cell that is affected. A synaptic connection between a neuron and a muscle cell is called a neuromuscular junction. So this is a diagram of synapse. Nerve impulse is coming. This is synaptic vesicles. These are mitochondrions. This is synaptic knob. This is synaptic knob. And this is synaptic gap. This is receptor site. So receptors are there. Dendrite of postsynaptic neuron. Means another neuron is going to start. And this is the gap between the two neurons. And this is neurotransmitter molecules within synaptic vesicle. Okay, hope so this structure is clear to you. Now, according to nature of connections, synapses are of three types. All types of synapses are found in cerebellum of brain. First one is axodendritic synapse. Second one is axosomatic synapse, and the third one is axonic synapse. Axon of one neuron terminates on the dendrites of another neuron and forms axodendritic synapse. axon of one neuron terminates on the cell body or soma portion of a second neuron and forms an axosomatic synapse. Axon of one neuron terminates on the axon of another neuron and forms axoaxonic synapse. And the next one is, what is the structure of synapse? At a chemical synapse, one neuron releases neurotransmitter molecules into a small space or synaptic cleft that is adjacent to another neuron. The neurotransmitters are contained within small sacs called synaptic vesicles and are released into the synaptic cleft by exocytosis. So, structure of synapse, you can say that under electron microscope, the terminal branches of the axon of the presynaptic part are found to end in certain expanded regions called synaptic knobs. They are present very close to the parts of the axon or dendrite or cell body of second neuron. Each knob is covered by an intact membrane called presynaptic membrane. The synaptic knob contains mitochondria and large number of vesicles called synaptic vesicles, which are filled with neurotransmitter substance or chemical material responsible for transmission of nerve impulse. Hope so, from this diagram you have understood the structure. This is synaptic knob. This is another synaptic knob. This is presynaptic membrane. These are neurotransmitter within synaptic vesicle. The part of second neuron or postsynaptic part is also covered by a membrane called postsynaptic membrane. The submicroscopic space is observed between the pre and postsynaptic membrane is called synaptic cleft, which is about 200 angstrom wide. In some synapses in brain cortex mainly contain several parallel intersynaptic filaments or synaptic canaliculi across the synaptic cleft, pre and postsynaptic membranes. This is synaptic cleft over here. Next, which connect the postsynaptic part, there are a net-like filaments which are found just below the postsynaptic membrane and extends up to a considerable distance in the cytoplasm. These are known as synaptic web. Now, mechanism of synaptic transmission. Transmission of nerve action potential, step by step, occurs as follows. The method of synaptic transmission is outlined below in 9 steps. First one, an action potential arrives at the synaptic knob over here. This causes calcium channels to open, allowing calcium ion, that is Ca2 plus ions, to flow into the synaptic knob. So calcium ion will be inserted into synaptic knobs. The increases in the calcium ion concentration causes vesicles containing the acetylcholine neurotransmitter to remove to the presynaptic membrane. The increase in the calcium ion concentration causes vesicles containing the acetylcholine neurotransmitter to remove the presynaptic membrane. The vesicles to move to the presynaptic membrane. That means from the vesicle, neurotransmitter, the acetylcholine, neurotransmitter acetylcholine will come out and it will move to the presynaptic membrane. Next, the vesicles fuse with the presynaptic membrane and discharge their content into the synaptic cleft. They'll fuse over here and discharge their content in the synaptic cleft. Molecules of acetylcholine then diffuse across the gap and fit into specific receptor sites on the postsynaptic membrane. You have seen in the previous slide, there are receptors also, so they will fit with these receptors. This then causes an alteration in the permeability of the postsynaptic membrane, which results in a movement of ions. Sodium ion, Na plus ions flow inwards, building up a charge known as the excitatory postsynaptic potential called EPSP. Once the EPSP reaches a threshold, an action potential is generated in the neurons. The acetylcholine is then broken down in the cleft by the enzyme acetylcholinesterase. Acetylcholinesterase. Please remember the spelling and learn the spelling properly. The products of breakdown are reabsorbed into the synaptic knob where they are resynthesized. So these are the 9 steps which involve the mechanism of synaptic transmission, and this is the diagram how it is occurring. Now, what is neurotransmitter? Neurotransmitters are chemical messengers that transmit a message from a nerve cell across the synapse to a target cell. Neurotransmitters are released from synaptic vesicles in synapses into the synaptic cleft, where they are received by neurotransmitter receptors on the target cell. In case of synapse, so this generally acetylcholine. This is acetylcholine as neurotransmitter, which is released from this vesicle and moves to the presynaptic membrane. These are receptors on the postsynaptic membrane. And this is synaptic cleft, that is synapse. And this is the vesicle. And this is the part of this neuron. Now, what is neurotransmitter? The neuromuscular junction, or NMJ, is a synaptic connection between the terminal end of a motor nerve and a muscle, that means skeletal, smooth, or cardiac muscle. It is the site for the transmission of action potential from nerve to the muscle. So, if you want to study about neurotransmitter, NMJ, or neuromuscular junction, about this you have to study. See this diagram, you will understand the mechanism. This is axon terminal, this is acetylcholine vesicle. This is synaptic cleft, this is postsynaptic membrane. Again, same thing will be repeated over here. This is acetylcholine vesicle. And here, you can see the mechanism. But this mechanism is not in your syllabus. You just read this portion as neurotransmitter. Okay? Now, CNS, or central nervous system, controls most functions of the body and mind. It consists of two parts, the brain and the spinal cord. The large expanded and tubular portions of the nervous system, that is brain and spinal cord, which lie within the craniovertebral axis from the structure system called central nervous system, or CNS. We all know that CNS consists of brain and spinal cord. So here is brain. The brain formed of three main parts. The forebrain consists of cerebrum, thalamus, and hypothalamus. Here all the divisions has been shown. The midbrain and the hindbrain consist of cerebellum, pons, and medulla oblongata. Pons, medulla oblongata, and from here spinal cord starts, and cerebrum and cerebellum are there. Number two, spinal cord. Now see this. This is spinal cord. Spinal cord consists of cervical vertebrae, thoracic vertebrae, lumbar vertebrae, and sacrum vertebrae. In your book, in case of neurotransmitter, in case of central nervous system, lots of things are there. Please go through your book, because this is class 11. Syllabus are very vast. Syllabus, all the chapters are very, very vast, huge. So it's not possible for us that we'll teach you line by line. That's why I'm giving you an idea so that easily you can understand it from your book. But If you will face any type of problem, maybe you are not understanding one terminology from your book, so please inform me through my mail. For subject related doubts or queries, please email me at sudeshna1.sma@outlook.com. We also welcome your responses by way of your views and feedback on the PPTs or videos at feedback.stmichaelsacademy@gmail.com. Thank you, students, and have a nice day.